know.
I'm Adora Nwofor, and I'm happy to be here for another celebration of creative Calgarians who make this city a better place by pursuing their inspiration and living their most authentic lives. Today, we join a multi-talented musician to discover the importance of sharing traditional music.
I feel like I'm already living in my dream in a way that everything I do is what I wanted to do.
Then, we meet the creative Calgarian behind a community art hub that celebrates Korean culture.
Women get together and we do have power. We sharing the food, we sharing our tradition.
Finally, let's mix it up with a long-standing local fixture of the DJ scene to see how the pandemic has changed his tune.
Everything was always kind of out of the mainstream. I kind of liked it that way.
This and more on Living a Creative Life. I'm an anth geek. That means I love culture and humankind. And this month on Living a Creative Life, I was so blessed to be able to talk to many people of Asian heritage. All cultures are beautiful, and I'm so lucky to be able to share in their creativity here on Living a Creative Life. Scanning the socials, we see urban sketching come to life posted by fire_power. And Alex Hunt Studio adds color with a vibrant floral painting. And check out this striking collection of landscapes by BR_busy. It's catch-up time with our friend Lon Ray. What's up, Lon Ray?
On the next episode of My City Speaks to Me, I'm talking about public arts in Calgary, the murals and the sculptures showcasing the creative works of Calgarian artists. Join me on this episode as I take you around the city, showcasing my 10 best public art in Calgary. See you there.
How does Jia Jia Li's work as the leader of the Calgary Chinese Orchestra motivate them to continue playing traditional Chinese music? Put your headphones on for this one, because you're going to love what you hear. It is a beautiful day here in Calgary, and I am so honored to be able to talk to a flautist today. Flutist, flautist, thank you for joining us today, Jia Jia Li, here on Living a Creative Life. You play on a woodwind. It's called a flute.
The bamboo flute, we call it. You put on a very thin layer of inner side of the bamboos, and it looks like onion skin. And then to create this kind of like really buzzing sound, make it super characteristic.
So how did you begin playing the diza?
I learned a little bit when I was young, but really not until I moved to Calgary. I just wanted to explore more of my own roots, finding out like my own identity and for this creative ways that the journey that I'm going. And I play with the Calgary Chinese Orchestra and ended up directing it. Most of our members are Chinese, and then this type of music and these instruments mean something to them. And so that is basically the goal and the mission of the orchestra, to promote and this type of music. And to me, like being able to witness all of that, and then the passion, the joy that when people are playing together, really makes me feel I am part of this community. I feel like I'm already living in my dream in a way that everything I do is what I wanted to do. I'm really hoping more people can join us playing on or try on these like beautiful instruments. And you know, in 10 years, if our orchestra is mixed with all type of people from all backgrounds, all race, all ages, I think that's the thing would just make me really happy.
Experiencing a lack of Korean culture in Calgary, Anna Ko saw an opportunity to share her culture through art. Let's see how that became something even bigger.
When did the Korean Art Club start here in Calgary?
Very beginning, ladies get together. Some of them is semi-retired, some of them is kids grown up, and they don't have any life. And they think it's so reality is tight for them, so they work and raise kids. And one of the ladies, a Korean, was artist, in training by artist. So we started into the Korean drawing, and that's how we started.
What types of Korean art are happening here?
As we do for the calligraphy, as well as traditional art, like watercolors, we do brush, rice paper with brush. Oh, that's what we were made. A lot of them is made by Korean. Yeah.
Remember.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah.
I also see a beautiful space here that's wide open. Is there dancing? Is there music?
Yes, we do have Korean traditional dancing and Korean traditional musicians, and we do have instrument, and which is we have all in here. And we have groups doing it for performance at Calgary Stampede, for example. Oh. We do there, and we do for the small town for event.
So there's dancing, and there's art, and there's music, and I feel like there's also food.
As you know, Korean food was pretty healthy, and we didn't have explore very much. And since we opening to the Korean cooking classes and stuff like that, and in Calgary City, people notice differences. Mm-hmm. And they see the more interesting about our food, our culture.
How does your community feel about having all those things available here?
As you know, it's a Korean community, in an Asian community, woman is not supposed to be outside workers, and mostly inside. And somehow we break through there. And beginning of a lot of people was pointing at us. But nowadays, we work more activity work than any other groups. Women get together and we do have power. We sharing the food. We give away food, and we sharing our tradition as well as other community. We join together. We has not this time, but we has sharing the food each other. We gonna bring together for their food and our food. We sharing all together, stuff like that. And people appreciate it right now, and they are more supportive these days.
So you have created a great space. Your community is supported. I feel like you've done so much already. So the Korean Art Club, what would you like to see happen next year and beyond?
Korean Art Club, I like to be for second generation. Our second generation continues using it, and they can see that their culture, their roots, where it come from, and they can direct to their life together. We can share with Canadian society as well, Korean society together, and their life can be more stronger, better. I hope that when doing it, and continuously we like to be keep going. We sharing the different things, and some degree of need the ladies, not only ladies, some families, we can able to support, guide them, and then more like a teaching. So I'm proud to be Korean. I'm proud to be I can able to handle this.
Having hosted Sunday School since 1996, possibly the longest running DJ residency in North America, let's see how the pandemic has affected DJ Rice and his groove.
How I got my name, DJ Rice, was I was a hip hop DJ. And in that era, everyone was ice everything, ice tea, ice cube. So naturally, I just call myself Rice. I haven't missed a night in 25 years. I made every Sunday since the first one in March of 1996.
What got you into house music? Like, why was that the choice?
I just love the feel of house music, from jazz to disco to funk. Latin. I just love the versatility of it.
Let's be honest, Calgary was not a house city.
You're
in
right.
Any way, shape, or
you're
form.
Absolutely right.
What was that like for you?
At the beginning, it almost made it easier because we were so underground. We were known as a country western town, and clubs were all top 40 and mainstream. So, I mean, I just found my place and people started to look up to me as a DJ, and you get followers and people that come out to specifically hear what you're playing and wondering, what is he going to present us tonight? You know, everything was always kind of out of the mainstream. And I mean, I kind of like it that way.
You've made your own version of typical.
It's a thrill to get up there in a nightclub, you know, in front of people. It's also scary because, I mean, you can't take your time and say, oh, I didn't like that, and I want to do that mix over. It's like, you're in it. You start out like, it's almost like an introduction where you bring it up to the climax, right? 2 o'clock at last call.
Right.
You get everyone hyped up and then you bring them down. You know, everyone has a different style of mixing, different style of tracks that they play. What they're known for, their sound. Guys don't even mix like me anymore. So my style is like more like how the hip hop funk guys used to play, you know?
Like you blend it together.
Yeah, bring it in, just like, guys, it's just a different style. Every time you play, you're striving for that perfect set, that perfect mix. And in 30, 35 years, I still don't think I've ever got that. I
mean, oh, maybe that's part of the gift. Yeah.
That is.
You're striving
for the perfect set. This pandemic's really changed things. I'm wondering if clubs will ever be the same. I started my Twitch channel and done it every Sunday since. It really has revitalized me, refreshed my whole outlook, and I'm going to continue streaming no matter what. I can't wait to see what it's going to be like after this pandemic, and I'm confident that it's going to be, a lot of people are going to be hungry to party.
The streets are calling my name, DJ Bryce, so hard. Thank you for all that you have given us already.
It's been a pleasure, and I just want to thank everyone that's come out over the years that supported me. Like, I'm going until my ears go out.
Thank you for sharing your stories, Calgary. If you have a project or an example of living creatively, please share to submissions@calgaryartsdevelopment.com or post online with the hashtag yycLCL. See you next time for more on Living a Creative Life.